Good morning, everyone. Myself, Vinita Singh Pariyar, resident at Department of Data Diagnosis, Savai Mansingh Medical College, Jaipur, Rajasthan. I am very thankful to MRI Teaching Course for giving me this wonderful opportunity to present my paper. And here I begin. The title of my study is to study MR imaging spectrum of orbital masses using DWI-ADC as a power tool to differentiate malignant and benign masses. Introduction. Orbital and intraocular masses are relatively uncommon compared to other mass regions of the body. Orbital masses comprise of heterogeneous group of disorders, including inflammatory, benign, malignant metastasis, in which at times differentiating benign and malignant orbital lesion is difficult due to the overlapping clinical presentation. MRI is a modality of choice. CT is helpful in cases of suspected bony pathologies and calcifications. Advanced MRI techniques like diffusion-weighted imaging with quantitative apparent diffusion coefficient mapping provide additional information about the orbital masses. Based on the diffusibility of water in tissue, DWI exploits the fact that movement of water is normally restricted in malignant tumors. DWI can be a helpful non-invasive technique to differentiate between benign and malignant orbital masses based on apparent diffusion coefficient values. Objective: to evaluate role of MRI in characterization for orbital masses, to distinguish benign and malignant masses using DWI with ADC mapping. Materials and methods. Patient with known or suspected orbital space occupying lesion presenting with ophthalmological complaints such as proptosis, visual impairment when included in the study. Study area was Department of Radio Diagnosis, Department of Ophthalmology, Savai Mansingh Medical College, Jaipur, Rajasthan. Study type was quantitative, design was analytical type of observation study, duration was that of 1 year, and equipment use was 3 Tesla MRI Philips Ingenia machine. Techniques: the following MRI protocol are followed. All cases were evaluated by DWI in exit planes with ADC map. Single shot ecoplanar DWI sequence was done. DWI is obtained with diffusion weighted factor using B value 0,500 and 1000 second per millimeter square. Region of interest analysis was performed by using measurements of areas of abnormality seen on conventional MRI sequences and adjusted according to the size of the lesion. To achieve standardized condition for result analysis and avoid data contamination from adjacent structure, RI was placed within the area of solid region of referred. Care was taken to avoid the edges to exclude the effect of partial volume averaging. Results: 47 patients with suspected orbital mass were evaluated using contrast enhanced MRI with DWI-ADC after taking relevant clinical history. Amongst 47 analyzed patients, 24 were malignant, rest 23 were benign. Histopathological examination and clinical follow-up were done to reach the final diagnosis. Male to female ratio is 1:2:1. Most common age group involved was 30 to 40 years. Mean age of presentation was 34 years. Common symptom of presentation was visual impairment, predominantly reduced vision, followed by proptosis. 88% malignant lesion showed diffusion restriction. 78% benign lesion, diffusion restriction was absent. The mean ADC in malignant lesion was 0.67 × 10⁻³ and benign lesion was 1.251 × 10⁻³ millimeter square per second. The difference in mean ADC of malignant benign lesion was statistically significant. ROC curve analysis revealed ADC value of 0.85 × 10⁻³ as cutoff for differentiation of malignant benign lesions, the sensitivity being 80 and specificity being 80%. Retinoblastoma had lowest ADC value in malignant lesion. Lymphangioma had highest ADC in benign lesions. Limitation were few of inflammatory lesion forming orbital cellulitis due to presence of purulent content showed diffusion restriction with low ADC mean being 0.557 amongst benign lesions. This table includes all the malignant orbital masses included in my study with the mean ADC values, lowest being that of retinoblastoma. This table is the list of all the benign orbital masses included in my study with the mean ADC values, highest being that of lymphangioma. This is the bar graph showing the mean ADC of malignant and benign orbital masses. This is the compartmental distribution of orbital masses into intraconal and conal, extraconal and multicompartmental. Now discussion. Malignant lesions have low ADC as compared to benign lesion, which is attributed to the fact that malignant lesions are hypercellular with enlarged nuclei having increased nucleus to cyclopolysmic ratio. This histological nature reduces available space for water proton diffusion in both intra and extracellular spaces, so result in decreased ADC values. In our study, taking ADC value of 0.85 × 10⁻³ millimeter square per second as threshold to differentiate malignant benign lesion has sensitivity of 80%. And specificity of 80%. Addition of DWI has led to increased accuracy of MR in characterizing indeterminate lesion, which would further help in patient management so that either early intervention or initial conservative treatment could be undertaken. Now, I'll be showing few of my cases, starting with case one, a 35-year female present with complaints of significant reduced vision. Axial T1-weighted shows a hyperintense intraocular mass, which is hypointense on axial T2 images, showing diffusion restriction, showing with corresponding fall in ADC of mean ADC values of 0.617 units 10 to the minus 3. This lesion came out to be ocular melanoma. Fall in ADC corresponds to the malignant orbital mass. Case 2, a 34-year-old female presented with complaints of proptosis, reduced vision, lacrimation. Axial MR sequence shows a well-defined extracorneal mass, which is isointense to muscle on T1, hyperintense on T2, showing increased diffusion with increased ADC, high signal intensity on ADC with ADC value of 1.61 into 10 to minus 3. It was a case of hemangioma and a benign lesion. Case 3, a 1-year-old child presented with proptosis of right eye. Axial MR sequence shows fusiform enlargement of the right optic nerve, which is isointense on T1, hyperintense on T2, showing increased diffusibility and high ADC value, mean being 1.88. The lesion was optic nerve glioma. Fourth case, a 66-year-old female presented with reduced vision and palpebral lateral orbital swelling. Axial MR sequences show diffuse enlargement of light trigeminal gland in the right supraorbital orbit, which is isointense both on T1 and T2, shows intense contrast enhancement. Diffusion restriction is present with fall in ADC, mean being 0.667 into 10 to minus 3. It was a case of lymphoma. Case 5, a 4-year-old boy present with leukochorea, T2-weighted axial and sagittal images showed a circumscribed retinal mass which is hypointense on T2, showing intense contrast enhancement, showing diffusion restriction with corresponding fall in ADC, the mean ADC value being 0.491 into 10 to minus 3. It was a case of retinoblastoma. Case 6, a 2-year-old child with known case of B-cell leukemia present with complaints of bilateral temporal swelling. MRI revealed bilateral symmetrical soft tissue masses on lateral orbital involving the lateral wall of the orbit, causing erosion of underlying bones. The lesion was isointense on T1 and that on T2, showing diffusion restriction, fall in ADC of 0.622 into 10 to minus 3. These were a case of leukemic infiltrate. The conclusion of my study is contrast in MRI is excellent imaging modality for vital lesion due to its superior soft tissue contrast, proper delineation of orbital compartment and depicting the extent of lesion. By analyzing, we have already observed that there is significant difference in ADC values of benign and malignant orbital masses. Hence, we conclude that DWI with ADC values or additional MRI sequences, which can be valuable non-invasive tools to predict malignancy and help guide appropriate management. These are my references. Thank you.